Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in North Carolina. Hey, I'm going to make a couple videos, and at first I want to make one while it's on my mind. Sister Ashley, I'll put the link below. Sister Ashley, I had visited in Arkansas, near Little Rock, Arkansas, last year, probably like October, I think it was, October, and I put a video of her testimony on here. Last year in October, and I haven't had a chance to talk to her while I was in the Philippines, and Sister Elaine had followed up with her, and Sister Elaine is the one who does the website, Church of the Firstborn, and she had followed up with her, and we'd found out that, you know, that she's not doing so great. I'm going to give her a call later on today, but I'll put the link below if you want to watch her excellent testimony, brothers and sisters, and I want you to pray for her. I'm asking for prayer. I'm going to do a video later on to pray for you guys and give you guys a word, but I ask you to pray for our sister Ashley in Arkansas, and I put the link below about her, and she needs our love and support, and this is the real purpose of the body of Christ. That's why I've been trying to get across in my videos, you know, as one of my teachings. It's not about us. JOY is the acronym to remember. Jesus first, others second, yourself last. And almost all the videos that I end up making is really about, you know, how the theme is. It's really the same thing that all these old churches are teaching, like the church I came out of. I came out of Assemblies of God Church when I was, I'd been an assistant pastor in a Baptist church, got filled with the Holy Spirit, then I transferred to, and then they began to mock it. I began to work as an altar worker in Assemblies of God Church while I went to Bible school and through Assemblies of God. And every week the sermon was like, for one thing, the pastor published his sermons for the quarter. For the whole next 3 months, some, you know, and the Lord don't operate like that, number one. It's one of those mega churches. And number two, every sermon is like how to be a better, you know, the 10-step program to be a better dad, how to be this, how to be that. Really, all the sermons that I've done is the Lord is just, I just got through praying, and the Lord was just showing me, you know, not condemning my sermons because they've been, you know, they've been, you know, what the Lord wanted me to say. But really, the underlying theme of most of my sermons, not the videos I did about dreams and prayers, or dreams and visions about the end times and all that. I'm talking about the preaching videos that I've done. The underlying theme is always about, you know, about you or about me, you know, repenting and, you know, getting closer to the Lord and all that. And, I mean, I already knew this, but the Lord just illuminated. That's how the Lord does. He gives a rhema word. He quickens things. So, it's not about you and it's not about me. So, I'm going to do a video about that. Let me cut this off and I'm going to come back and do a video that the Lord wants me to do about Moses.